About the general development of the EIA and the Norway grants in Romania, what are the expected results of these programs, and what do you think is the result so far?
We are in the second phase of the funding. The objectives remain the same as they were in the first round. Contributing to reducing social and economic disparities in Romania and in Europe in general for all the EIA beneficiary states, and also to enlarge and to widen the bilateral contacts and relations between, in this case, Norway and Romania. And I think we are on a good track, that is what I hear. And a good track and a good progress in very many of the programs.
What are the major changes you think these programs will bring in Romania? Because we
reducing social and economic disparities, we can translate that into giving even more people access to health services, to education, to infrastructure, contributing to creating a welfare state that embraces the whole population, which is the overall objective also for Europe as such. So contribution in that respect, I think, is what we can hope to see. And I think we will see very many good results during the years to come.
What is the feedback you received from the institutions involved in these programs, both in Romania and then at the administration level of the program?
Yeah, that is a very interesting dimension, that institutions both on the Romanian side and on the Norwegian sides, and individuals involved in various programs, in general, they give a very positive comment and feedback on the fact that they have a chance to working together, learning from each other, and also a very high degree of appreciation of the knowledge the other part is bringing into the program. And I'd like also to add that also in the Norwegian institutions, they emphasize that they also learn a lot. This is a mutual learning process, and a possibility of building mutual knowledge, but also building the respect and tolerance and interest and about each other and about each other's country.
Because the first round of the NGO fund is finished, we have the projects financed. Do you think that the projects? In other words, how would you comment the quality of the projects if you have a general vision about this? The subjects they approached or the impact they expect, can you comment?
It's a bit difficult for me to comment on the project as such, but as I understand, covering a wide range of issues, from environmental related issues to access to early education to raising awareness among the rights within the Roma community. So all in all, I think there are many good examples. There are good ideas, and that would be my general answer. But I'm what I've seen of some of the projects that were funding under the previous funding period has been very encouraging in, for instance, contributing to giving services in a community, health or assisting kids in their after-school activities or doing their studies, and then thereby also stimulating the general tolerance and acceptance within village, for instance. It has been very, very positive. So I think there are many creative ideas and creative ways of addressing issues through this this funding scheme, for instance, under the NGO fund, that I find very inspiring.
A specific aspect related to the process of contacting the partners, two of our readers who followed our interview today asked what could they do better in order to find partners in Norway, because they tried to find partners and they didn't, they sent the emails and requests and the partners didn't answer. Could you make some recommendations for them?
Yeah. First of all, it's unfortunate to hear that they perceived it as very difficult or didn't get through in a way. It's the Helsinki Committee in Oslo that is the main contact point, and our advice when we had this session is to the advice to the NGOs or the organizations is to be as specific as and clear as possible in order for the Helsinki Committee to forward it to the right receiver in the other end. Also, we should add that the Norwegian NGOs, they are contacted. They receive approaches. They receive requests from many countries, and of course, it's an issue of capacity on the Norwegian side as well. But be as concrete and specific as possible, and also add to that. It takes time, so maybe also include in the planning process that it will take a little time, and don't give up the first round.